Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Aviral and I have started a series on signal and power integrity design rules and simulation rules. And for this series, I'm using a particular book for reference. So I'm using Signal and Power Integrity Simplified by Eric Bogatin. And if you want to purchase this book, you can simply go to the Amazon and from there you'll find Kindle and hardcover both editions. I'll put that link in the description so you can directly go from there. Okay, so let's open the index first. So let's go to the page number 15, and here you'll find these two appendix. One is 100 general design guidelines to minimize the signal integrity problems. Another is 100 collected rules of thumb to help estimate signal integrity effect. Okay, so again I'm going to discuss every rule one by one. So let's start with the first rule. So I'm just clicking on this one. And here you'll find a rule number 0, which is always use the longest rise time as you can. Okay. So let's see where this particular point is mentioned in very detail. So I've noted down that particular page also, that is page number 36. And if I'll go there, this particular paragraph, and if you read this, I'm just zooming a little bit. Yeah, so the impact on a signal from any discontinuity depends on rise time of the signal. So that means if there will be like continuous changing impedance, either you are switching the layers or you didn't properly define the impedance, then there will be a problem with the rise time of signal. Okay, and as the rise time gets shorter, the magnitude of the distortion will increase. So here the distortion, as you can see in this particular signal, these are the distortions, right? And if rise time will be very narrow, then this distortion will be very high, right? So here he is giving one more example. So again, this rise time is directly connected to frequency. So this means the discontinuity that was not a problem in 33. So here he want to say, like, if frequency is 33 megahertz, maybe there will be no discontinuity problem, right? But again, if you go for higher frequency, there will be a problem with discontinuity. So that means our track should be properly defined, as you know, from impedance point of view. Okay, so again here we have find two points. Again he is saying one more thing. So that also depends on the packages impedance, because there will be lead, right? So in case of packages, there should be also impedance control packages. Okay, so that is, so here we find two things. One is related to impedance and another is related to rise time, right? So again, I've noted down these two points. First is impedance should be controlled from the driver to receiver. Okay, another point is the rise time of the signal. So where I found this relation? So again, this relation is given on the book. If I'll go to the, again, page number 15, which is our content, and here go to the this collected rules of thumb, and here you'll find the very first rule, which is the relation between rise time and frequency. Okay, so here we are talking about the clock frequency of particular chip. Okay, so from there I've noted down this same thing. So here you'll find the relationship between rise time should be almost equal to 1/10 of the clock period of frequency, right? And how we calculate the clock period? It is 1 by frequency, right? So again, for 100 megahertz, so here you can just remember this rule by this. The 100 megahertz clock has a rise time of about 1 nanosecond, right? So if this is the case, you'll find minimum distortion. Okay, so I've noted down all the pages also, if you're going to purchase the PDF or Kindle edition. So let's open the Hyperlinux, and I'm going to use this model for rise time demonstration. And here I'm using a simple counter circuit, and its clock can go up to 25 to 50 megahertz. And here we have one driver, okay, one receiver, and we have one transmission line. So right now you can see the properties of transmission lines. It is impedance is 63.3 ohm, and if I double click on this one, you can see the length and width of this one, okay, and all the electrical properties are mentioned in the particular section. Okay, so with default configuration, let's see what is the rise time and how is our waveform received at the receiver end. So let's open the CRO, and I'm just going to erase this one and just so here I'm just going to plot the waveform for driver as well as receiver and start the simulation. So you can see here I'm using 50 megahertz waveform with 50% duty cycle. So let's start the simulation, and here you can see there are a lot of distortion on the waveform, right? So I was talking about this one, okay? And so again, U1 is the green one is our at the driver side, and the red waveform is for the receiver end. So now how we can solve this? So again, as I mentioned, we have to, you know, either increase the rise time and another rule is we have to maintain the impedance throughout the track. So how to do that? So from this particular model, we can see from the data sheets, the impedance of the track should be 50 ohm, okay? So how we can change that? So we'll see from the setup, stack up, go to the edit, and here put the target impedance 50 ohm. And it will say for single-ended waveform, for single-ended connection, its width should be 9.56 mil, okay? And from the termination wizard, if you'll run the termination wizard, from here also you can see, okay, so it needed a series termination, which should be 53.9 ohm, okay? And the length between driver to receiver should be less than 1.3 inch, okay? So we'll implement these changes also, and let's see what will be the waveform. So again, double click on this one and go to the values, and from here we'll see it should be 1.3 and the width should be 9.56 mil, okay? And we'll add a series termination. So again, we always add series termination on the driver side. And what will be the value of that? It was 53, right? Okay. Now let's run the oscilloscope again. And I'm just going to plot the previous results also. So left click on this one. So before erasing this one, I just want to mention the rise time of the receiver end. So right now the rise time is around, okay, so I have to select the waveform first. From here, just select it and click over rise time. So right now you can see the rise time is 0.7 nanosecond, okay? Now I'm just going to plot the latest waveform and let's see. Okay, perfect. So I'm just going to hide this one and this, and for older one, I'm just going to use the another color. So let's say I'm just going to use a yellow color for older one, and this is the latest waveform, and let's see the rise time of the latest waveform is. So let's uncheck this one. Okay, it's selected. From here it's selected, and click over the rise time, and here you can see we have increased the rise time by adding the series termination and by impedance of the track, okay? So as you can see, now you can simply compare, okay? So our waveform is very much improved now, right? So this is the rule number zero from the book. And if you guys have any doubt, you can comment your doubts in the comment section, and I'll reply those as soon as possible. So thank you.